This is Dr. John D. Horn High School, Jaguar Country. The school is a 5A high school with a student body of almost 2,300. It is a diverse campus, but much like any other high school in the United States, the students tend to separate themselves into easily identifiable groups. Some might call them cliques. The smart kids hang out together, as do the cheerleaders and softball girls. Groups form around extracurricular activities and on racial and ethnic lines. Some form because of common interests, like the anime club and the frisbee golf group. Tonight, a group of students have gotten together to help make a change. This is Challenge Night, if you really knew me.
All right, welcome to Challenge Night, people. We're gonna have some fun, maybe a little. And we're gonna have some stuff that's probably not very fun, but we're gonna get to know each other a little bit better. And I think that's really important. So we're gonna start off with doing just some activity. Yeah. Go! Woo! Iceberg effect. Any of y'all remember the iceberg effect?
Nope.
Avery, you want to tell us about it?
The top of the iceberg is like 10% of what we show to people, and the bottom is like 90% is what we really are, like our true self.
This is called your image. And you could say that this is kind of the fake you. Sorry. But it is, okay? Down here, under the waterline, is the real you that only your closest friends get to see. So today we're gonna try to move this waterline down and maybe we can show just a little bit more of who you really are, okay? So we're not gonna ask you to do anything or say anything or tell anything that I wouldn't tell you myself. If you really knew me, you would know that when I was your age in high school, I was a singer. And I always had in my mind that I would be a singer when I grew up. So I graduated from high school, got a job singing in the theater, and I had two rock bands that I sang with. And then I started college, and I majored in music in college, and then something bad happened. I lost my voice completely. I had surgery, and then after the surgery, when I was supposed to be all better, it just didn't come back. The band that I was in went on to have all this success, and I got to sit and watch them on TV as I sat at home unable to even speak. At the time, it felt like I sort of lost who I was. I thought that music was who I was. My whole being was wrapped up with that. And without it, well, who was I? And it took several years, probably more than several, for me to realize that wasn't really who I was. That's one of the things I could do. But it's not who I was deep inside. So that was my story. What do we do after that? Oh, thank you. So if we really knew you, think about this. If we really knew you, what would we know? What would we know about you if we really knew you? Close your eyes. Think about what is your story. What's behind the mask? What's inside your image? Say to yourself, if you really knew me, you would know that, dot, 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 and then you're going to fill in the blank. And so here's a question I want you to think about before we start. If you really knew me, you would know that what I find most difficult about coming to school is, and then fill that in.
If you really knew me, you would know that I am scared of coming to school because I'm afraid of getting made fun of or the things I can't change, like the fact that I can't walk in a straight line. I can't control my left side very well. And it's hard to come to school knowing that I was once an athlete who ran every day and who threw a softball every day. And it's hard to know that I probably will never be able to play softball again, or even possibly never run again. And just really rough coming to school knowing that I'm not normal like everybody else.
If you really knew me, you'd know that the most difficult thing about coming back to school for me is that I'm gonna have to put on this fake smile again, because a lot of people don't know all the pain that I've gone through and how hard it is for me to, how hard my struggle is when I'm in school and everything else. And I was told by my family that all my family, we had a big family reunion, and I was repeatedly told again that I better do something great because all my family thinks that I'm gonna be this great thing, and I'm nervous that I'm not gonna fill their fill what they made for me. Like, I don't think that I'm just gonna be able to do it.
But this is my comfort zone. It's very small. And all of you guys have comfort zones. And why is it hard to step out of your comfort zone?
You're scared of what
people
are
going to think about you.
Did everybody hear that? I heard it over there too. It's fear. It's fear. You don't know what people are going to think. Are they going to think you're, you know, a real dork or hyper emotional or whatever? So, it's okay today to step out of your comfort zone. In fact, it takes courage, but you guys can do it. And frankly, it can start to feel like a prison. You know, if I've got to stay just in this little one comfort zone all the time and not do anything that doesn't fit within this square, it is kind of like a prison. So today's your chance to step out of it. Get out of prison, express yourself, the whole bit, okay?
If you really knew me, you know that I'm a cancer survivor of Hodgkin's disease lymphoma. It's cancer in the lymph nodes, and I was diagnosed at the end of my freshman year, and I did chemotherapy the whole summer. And like after that, like before that, I had like long hair, and like that was kind of like my trademark. And once I went through that, I was kind of like ashamed afterwards. So I wore a wig for like most of my sophomore year. And people would ask me, is that your real hair? And I'd be like, yes, because I would lie, because I was kind of ashamed of, you know, my hair missing.
If you really knew me, you'd know that I used to be, like, my best friend started taking me to church when I was in, like, 7th grade, when I used to get started and stuff. And so I got really into it, and we had a lot of fun. And, like, stuff was, like, corrupted there. And, like, it wasn't, like, how a church environment should be. Like, got into drugs or whatever. And, like, I got caught with it, and my stepdad does them, and so when he found them, it was hard for like my mom to see me doing like what he does. Like, it was really hard for my mom because like, we struggle already, like with two incomes, and so like, with one, like we didn't know how we were gonna make it really. And so, like, words were exchanged between me and my stepdad that, like, can't be taken back, really. And, like, no matter, like, how much time or whatever, like, it can't heal it, really. And so, like, now I try to, like, act like it all happened. Like, a happy family and, like, an informal. But, like, it doesn't work. And, like, I just can't change, really.
You, your brother, your sister have either physically or emotionally hurt each other. Think think while you're there, what if your brother or sister were not here tomorrow? Is there anything you'd want to say? Step over the line if you, a close friend, or a family member has ever had a problem with alcohol or other drugs. Step over the line if you have ever been hurt or judged because of the color of your skin. Step over the line if you've ever been yelled at, or screamed at, or ridiculed, or put down on a regular basis. Step over the line if you've ever felt alone or afraid. Put your left arm around the person on your left. Put your right arm around the person on your right. That is the love you guys deserve. You can come on across.
This part of Challenge Night is called Speak Out. So speak out loudly, use your voice, and tell us what you can do to make changes in our school as a result of tonight.
We need to realize that people are dealing with things that we don't know about, and when you bash them down, it makes them feel worse because you don't know how they're feeling inside, really.
I mean, a friendship can be made from just one moment or just speaking to everybody and smiling at them, and you can make their day, and you never know what may happen. So I think you should just always have an open mind about everybody and not think that because they're different from you, you're not going to be able to, you know, be a friend or just, you know, have a conversation.
We just have to get out of our comfort zones and be okay with getting out of our cliques and going out to other groups and including them. And we need to be more together because nothing gets accomplished whenever we're all in our own little groups.
We've all felt alone before, and we've all, you know, been afraid to, like, just, you know, be ourselves at times. And if you think about it, if we just, like, realize that, you know, none of us are alone because we all made the realization that we felt alone. So, I mean, we're all in this together, and if we realize that, I think we can be a really great class this year.
Us as leaders of our certain particular groups, together we can bring everyone together and make a stronger senior class, and then reach out to the juniors, and the juniors can reach out to the sophomores to the freshmen, and we can cover the entire school just by being together and, you know, just having more nights like these where we get to know each other and we can interact at the school.
Well, can we commit to making that change, to trying every day to step out of our comfort zones and try to sit with somebody different in the cafeteria? Even if you just did it once a week, it could be enough to make a big change. And you know, Gandhi said, be the change that you wish to see in the world. So why don't we do that? Wouldn't it be cool if our whole cafeteria was just all jumbled up? I think it would. So I challenge all of you to do that. Are you guys committed to this?
Yes.
Do you think it'll make our school better?
Yes.
All right, let's do it! Woo!